Good morning. Welcome to the Children's Storytime. I want to invite children of all ages to come and join me. But this morning, our topic is hidden under this orange piece of paper. I will reveal it later, but stick with me to find out what our topic is for today. But first, I have a question for you. What is your favorite costume that you have ever worn? Yeah, it's fun sometimes to wear a costume and get to be somebody else, and then you can take it off and be yourself again. I have some costumes for my head that I'm gonna put on and see if you can guess who I am, okay? If you're on the live Zoom worship meeting, you can type it in the chat if you feel like you are capable or comfortable doing that, or you can just say it out loud in your house who you think I am. And I think they're pretty easy to guess for the most part. All right, let me do this first one and see if you can guess who I am. Ready? Ooh, okay. Who am I with this hat? I'm a chef. I'm a chef in this hat. Good guessing. All right, here's the next one. Let me see if I can get it ready. Okay, here. Here we go. Who am I in this hat? Oink, oink. I'm a piggy. Okay, here's the next one. It's a mask. Who am I now? I'm Spider-Man or Spider-Woman. All right. Ooh, I gave you a sneak peek of this next one. This one doesn't fit my head very well. I don't know that any of them do, but who am I in this hat? I'm the queen in this hat, or king, or someone in the royal courts. All right, who am I in this hat? Yeehaw! I'm a cowgirl in this hat. Okay, this last one, I don't know how easy it will be to figure out who I am with this hat, but good luck. Okay, can you tell what kind of a hat this is? This is called an aviator's hat, meaning for someone who flies airplanes. I actually kind of hear one right now. They don't wear these nowadays, but these are a kind of aviator hat they used to wear. Okay, well, good job guessing all of those costumes. I hope that was fun for you. One of the things that is fun about wearing costumes is, you know, pretending to be somebody else. Like if you've always wanted to be a cowgirl or a chef or whoever, if you're inspired by somebody and you want to dress up and be like them for Halloween, that's really kind of fun to do. And the reason I had us doing that is because on Palm Sunday, when Jesus came into Jerusalem on a donkey, all the people there thought, "Ah, Jesus is coming to be the king of Israel." They thought he's going to wear a crown and sit on the throne and be in charge of the government of the nation of Israel. But surprise, here's our lesson. Jesus came to be the king of our hearts, not the king of a nation. And so the people thought, oh, he looks like it, and it looks like he's going to be the king. Even though he wasn't wearing a costume, they thought he's going to be the king of a country. But he said, no, I've come to be the king of your hearts. And so I am grateful that Jesus came to live and rule inside of me and everyone else who wants Jesus to be in charge of them and to be the king of their hearts too. I hope and pray that you want Jesus to be the king of your heart too. He is the best, kindest, most helpful king there ever was. And I love having him be in my heart and in my life. And I hope you'll want him to be the king of your heart and life as well. So let's pray and thank God for sending Jesus to be the king of our hearts. Ready? Open and close, open and close. Give your hands a clap. Open and close, open and close. Fold them in your lap. Dear God, thank you for loving us so much and coming, Jesus, to be the king of our hearts. Not the king of a small country or a government in some part of the world, but that you're in every part of the world because you're in our hearts. When we trust in you and believe in you, help us to follow you and let you be in charge of us because you're so good and trustworthy and you love us so much. Help us to trust you and let you be in charge. We thank you, we love you, and we pray all this in Jesus' name, and all God's children said, amen. All right, I love you and I will see you in Children's Church where we're going to praise Jesus even more. So I'll see you then. Bye.